Hello, hello everybody, and welcome. In this series, I will be seeking to accurately translate biblical words, the words that are in a language that is not English. This language is said to be Hebrew, and I will talk about that as well, but in a later video. We know that the Bible, the languages in the Bible are straight up Bantu languages. And so I will be talking from the perspective of a Bantu speaker. And the language I'll be referencing is LuYah. LuYah is a tribe that's found in Western Kenya and Eastern Uganda, some, okay? If you have any questions after you listen to this, feel free to email me at divineplatformtruth@gmail.com. So Eli Eli Lama SabaChatani is found in Matthew 27:46. And about the ninth hour, Jesus cried with a loud voice, saying, Eli, Eli, Lama, SabaChatani, that is to say, my God, my God, why hast thou forsaken me? So what exactly is the meaning of what Jesus said on the cross at the ninth hour? I will break this down syllable by syllable, okay? So the first word is Eli, but the Bantu would say it Eli, and it's repeated. So let's go step by step and see what that means. So if we just take it as one word without repeating it, Eli, that's what it means. It means this is. So for instance, if I said Eli Nelianje, this literally means this is mine. This is mine. Okay. Eli also means possession. So for instance, if I said Elin Nayo, it means I have it. Or if I said Elin Naye, means I am with him or her. Okay. The third interpretation of Eli Eli is as a proper noun. In some scriptures, it's quoted as a proper noun with the E capitalized. So it's quite possible that here Jesus was calling on someone or even on God, because we know he was going, even in the Garden of Gethsemane, he was wary, he was troubled with what he was to face, which was dying on the cross. So it's quite possible that he was calling on someone. Eli, Eli, Lama SabaChatani. The fourth interpretation would be combining the two words, Eli, Eli, and that gives us Eli, Eli. And, you know, vowels are interchangeable. So if we changed, if we switch the I for an A, we'd get Elila. That literally means I cry in the present participle that's ending in ing. So it would be like, I'm crying. Literally, that's what it would mean. I'm crying right now. And we know the verse says he cried. So he was literally crying. So it means literally crying, I'm crying. Okay, and the fifth possible interpretation is when we switch out the L and the R. We know that this is interchangeable in the Bantu languages. So if we switched out, we'd get Eri, Eri. And if we combine this, It would mean, it means erire, I am afraid. It literally means I am afraid. Okay, now to the next word, lama. Lama comes from lament, as in lamentations. Literally, it just comes from that. This is an expression of sorrow or to grieve audibly. And this is a common practice with in Africa and even in America with our African-American brothers, you know, when they say, oh, why, what have you done to me? Why are you doing this? Oh my God. It's kind of a lamentation. Oh my God, what have I done? Oh God, please help me. You know, when you're crying like that, it's almost a lamentation. You're like, oh, the night is coming. What am I going to do? So that's what lama literally means. It's an expression of sorrow. It's to grieve audibly. Now, saba. Saba has several meanings, but in this context, it means to ask, to beg, or to beseech. If you have a chance to watch my other video on the Sabbath, you'll see all the meanings of the word saba. But in this context, it means to ask, to beg, or to beseech. And now the final syllable, katani. So in Bantu, k, that sound is never written like this. So for every k sound, it's always a k. So katani would be katani with a k. And this literally means, oh, even, or oh, man, or oh, boy. Or why? It's an expression of exasperation, despair. So like the common usage equivalent is, oh man, oh why, oh boy, like oh man. Okay, the other pronunciation of this CH is SH. In Bantu, it would be written as SH. So you would not write CH and say SH. So in that sense, Katani means Shetani. And Shetani literally means the devil. So, and the common usage equivalent of that is, oh, the devil. And that's a common expression. When somebody does something wrong or something goes wrong, you say, oh, I, that blah, 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 oh, the devil. That's a very common expression. So already that tells you that this was happening in a Bantu-speaking area. This Jesus crucifixion was happening in a Bantu-speaking area, okay? So now let's bring it all together. Eli, Eli, but would say it, Eli, Eli, Lama SabaChatani. So that would mean I'm crying, I'm beseeching, I'm begging, like, oh man. Or I'm crying, I am praying, I am pleading, oh the devil. Or Eli Eli as a proper noun would mean you're calling somebody's name, Eli Eli, I'm pleading, I'm asking, oh man, or Eli Eli. I'm pleading, I am asking, or the devil. Okay? And that's what it means. There's a lot of other interpretations out there. Look at the Bantu interpretations, because Jesus was Bantu speaking. So if you want to get accurate translations, listen to the Bantu interpretations. They might be a little bit different. Use a discerning spirit, but they're more likely to get you to the truth than any other interpretation out there. If you have any questions, feel free to reach out to divineplatformtruth@gmail.com. And thank you so much for watching.